What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, it's your homie, Futuristic Mike. Welcome back to another The Last of Us video. Now, this is going to be the review for The Last of Us Season 1, Episode 7, titled Left Behind. Now, this one, I enjoyed the least out of everyone so far, man. This is my least favorite episode. I'm going to give it a 7.5 out of 10. It was good. It was just a little slow. I understand a slow-paced episode in the series. You know, there has to be an episode like that sometimes, but it was just kind of boring to me, this episode. It was like a filler episode. It wasn't necessarily needed, but it is what it is. I guess the Riley story is from a DLC, and I never played the DLC. Like, I didn't really know anything about Riley until recently. So you could honestly probably skip this episode and be okay, because if you played the game, if you played the regular story and stuff, this episode is not needed, in my opinion. At the beginning of the episode, we just seen Joel. You know, he was still hurt and Ellie was trying to take care of him and stuff. And then we see, you know, a flashback to when this stuff all started. She just looks back on the night that changed everything. You see where Ellie is at, you know, where she was at before Joel ended up taking her. And Riley snuck out, but she snuck back in the window. And Riley wants Ellie to sneak off with her so she can show her some things. We just see the two of them bonding. You know, they have a real good relationship. They're best friends. But you can tell there's more there. You can tell Ellie really likes Riley. And in the game, they shared a kiss, I guess, or whatever. At least that's what I read. I'm not sure because I haven't played it. But we see Riley. She just takes Ellie to this abandoned mall. They're exploring the mall. There's not much left of it. But there is some great cinematography in this episode, man. The shots were beautiful. I was loving the lights, all the shots. It was just great. We just see the two of them, you know, roaming around the mall, looking around, just having some fun, man. You know, Riley is taking Ellie to all the best spots in the mall. They go in one of those photo booth things. They take some pictures, you know, some funny photos. And I guess they had a part like this in the DLC too. I seen a picture of it where Riley and Ellie took these funny pictures. I'm sure all you guys that played the DLC could really appreciate this episode and the little details in the episode. You know, Ellie gets mad at Riley, like really upset and mad because Riley said she was leaving. She was trying to say goodbye and stuff and Ellie wasn't having it. She was super upset because there was feelings there. And Ellie ended up finding out that Riley took her there to the mall because Riley was going to try to get Ellie put there with her on an assignment. Because I guess Riley was posted up there. They made Riley stay there and take care of some things. So Riley was going to try to see if Ellie could stay there with her. Now this episode didn't have much action, man. Not a lot of infected or nothing. We just see a part where there's this infected in the mall. And some stuff ends up going down. That's all I'm gonna say. It happens towards the end of the episode. Like the first, I don't know, 45, 50 minutes. It's just, you know, Riley and Ellie doing what they're doing. And we don't get this stuff with the infected until way later. I believe the episode was a little over like an hour long too. Like an hour and 10 minutes almost. So yeah, we didn't get much infected in this episode. We didn't get much action. And not much Joe at all. It was an Ellie and Riley centered episode for the most part. But I'm still happy we seen Joe in this episode. I'm glad he made an appearance at least. I just wish we got more of Joe because I'm really loving Pedro Pascal as Joe. And I wanted to see more of him on the screen. But it's okay. We still got two more episodes left. And I know the last two episodes are going to be really, really good. So far, there's not amazing things being said about this episode. Not necessarily negative things or whatever, but people just aren't feeling the fact that it was as boring as it was. But it's okay, though. It was good for what it was. We can't even be too picky because this show has been so great so far, man. Honestly, the best episodes, in my opinion, are episode 1 and 5. If I'm remembering correctly, those were the best ones, the absolute best ones right there. Those were great watches. Now, one thing I did appreciate about this episode, though, was the fact that they showed when Ellie got bit, man. We never actually seen how that happened in the game.
So I appreciated that scene right there where it showed how she got bit, and also Riley got bit as well. Ellie got bit on the arm and Riley got bit on the hand. And you gotta remember, these are just girls, man. They're not experts at killing these infected and stuff like that. You know, Riley, she has some experience, but she's not an expert at it. And Ellie, this is way before she met Joel, man. She doesn't know what she's doing. So it was hard to fight off that infected. So they got bit. So yeah, I did love seeing that moment. And I like to see, you know, the relationship between Ellie and Riley. That was cool. They shared a kiss or whatever. But overall, the episode was just mid, in my opinion. It could have been better, but it is what it is. It was more of a filler episode. Comment your thoughts down below. Let me know all your thoughts. What are your theories, thoughts, predictions, and everything else for the next episode, the rest of the season? Let me know. We don't got many episodes left, but let me know all your thoughts. Keep supporting your boy, and I'll be continuing to bring y'all the Last of Us content in the future.
Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and smash that notification bell so you can never miss a video. If you guys want to donate to the channel, I got links below to the PayPal and Cash App accounts. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me get out of here, y'all. It's your boy, Futuristic Mike, and I'll talk to you on the next one. I'm out. Peace.